one more place we can discover today together is the tools. So we're still at the resources side. Over the tools, you set your preference, the language available for you over here. If you see, we do have Arabic, we have English, we have French. Arabic one that can come in hand for those who they have some learning disabilities because of the language barrier. They're not good in English. Arabic one could help them. Still English, it's the preferable one. You do have different languages. Let's say that you have students who is a Turkish student and his English is bad and he doesn't understand even Arabic. This one gives him a chance to, you know. But unfortunately, not all the resources that are available with the language over here provided. So let's say, let's take, for example, the resources for IT Essential, PC hardware and software. Now you see we have different versions. Version 4.1 is similar to version 4.0. The difference over here, we have for Windows 7 and Windows Vista. Windows 7 and Windows Vista is going to be optional. Not necessarily we are going to discuss it. The same happens in your labs. If you use Windows XP, you don't need to introduce Windows Vista or Windows 7 from time to time. You show the students, and you'll find some lab activities that they are optional for Windows Windows 7. You show the students, you know, how to access, how to do the things, the same things with Windows 7. Again, it's you are the one who's going to customize it. So over here, I'm gonna go find tools for the instructor materials. Over here, what do we have? I want to ask you, Muhammad, or you, Marlon, are you part of the KHDA? Does the KHDA comes and check your curriculum, and do they inspect you, the KHDA, Knowledge and
no.
Human Resources Development Authority?
No, never heard of it.
Okay. Now, in Dubai, as part of the schools, the private schools, in Dubai, they are under the KHDA authority, where they check the curriculum, they check everything. They sit in the school for 3 days or 1 week sometimes. They see all what the instructors are doing. They enter the classroom together with the instructors, and later on they issue a ranking, school ranking system, where you can go and see the school ranking and choose the best school for your kids. They ask you or the principal asks you or any other authority about the curriculum, the materials, about the mapping that you're teaching, the scope and sequence that you're teaching for IT Essential. Those resources you can get from over here. For example, the detailed syllabus from 1 to 10. This one shows you detailed syllabus and details of 1 to 10 chapters. Let me maximize it over here.
Is this what we are using now, 4.1, okay, yeah.
Yes. You know, using the online meeting at the same time recording, PDF, you know, goes crazy. So just let's give it a minute till it opens properly. I cannot control it, like it's stuck.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, but let me, in the meantime, talk about it. In this part, it doesn't only show the titles, scope and sequences, it shows you as well how and each of the modules, how much time is going to take. Let me talk a little bit about the time. The training, as for you as an instructor, they are different from the students' training. Students, they shouldn't get less than, let's say that you are going to cover everything, less than 60 to 70 training hours. So over here, this one described what happened to it. Okay, this one, let's say this one is chapter 1. It shows you that chapter 1, no, we went to day 6 and 7. This is Okay, this one is chapter 1. Shows you that, by the way, chapter 1 is the longest one. You'll see today. Today we are going, I'm planning to cover chapter 1, 2, and 3. In chapter 1 over here, you see that it takes approximately 15% of the 70 hours that we are recommending over here. That's around 10.5 hours. 10.5 hour. This one shows you, like, in day one, what do you introduce, the class introduction and everything. Day two, introduce the online curriculum. So it's we're taking over here around the 2 to 3 sessions introducing the. Now coming to the instructor lab manual. This instructor lab manual, it contains all the labs that I'm going to show you shortly. You have all the labs. They are collected together in one lab activity book. You can print it and use it. Now I have printed already your lab activities. They are sitting over there in my lab. I'll share them with you once we come to the class. So for your case, Muhammad, later on you are going to choose the best lab activities that they are suitable for your students. Collect them and print them. And to do this, this is the best place to get. This one is the instructor lab manual. You don't need it for the time being because you are not instructor lab yet. You have it for the student's lab manual, which is this one. Student lab PDF files. This one. Although I have it, but I don't know why it's downloading it again. Let's give it a few minutes to be downloaded. So the student lab file, what's the difference between this student lab manual and this student lab PDF files? The student lab manual, as I told you, it's one bundle. It's one book. You send it to be printed. But believe me, it's very big because over there you have the optional one, Windows 7. And even I stopped printing them because they consume a lot of papers. So I choose the one for the previous model. You remember we had IT Essential 4.0 and 4.1, 4.1 that has the Windows 7. That one didn't have Windows 7. Since I have in my lab, I have Windows XP, and my students are have they use Windows XP, for example, let's say, I choose that one. So over here, once we download and open the student lab resource file, you'll see what I mean with the lab resource file. The packet tracer manual is different, okay? But you don't need the manual for packet tracer. We'll see whenever we have an activity, we'll do that activity in time. These are the Windows 7. They are, again, they're collected with the different instructor lab PDF files. This one's these guys for Windows 7. Okay, now for example, for chapter 1, these are the PDF files, which you'll find them later on after, at the end of each of these modules, you'll find the link for each of the guys I'm showing you over here, but they are collected in one place. For example, this lab activity, this one is a lovely lab activity where the students are going to be given a worksheet that they research the computer components. And over here it's very practical one where they can discuss about the cost and price of each of the computer components. This one makes the students more capable of going out to the shops and purchasing their equipments by themselves if they know the approximate cost of each of the equipments. Okay, so this is one of the black worksheet that you wish to download it, print it, and give it to the students and assign it as a task and grade it, because grading these worksheets is essential for the students to feel that it's a serious work. For example, over here, this is one activity that could be done using the packet tracer over here. Again, I'm having the same problem with PDF. Over here. Over here, for example, this one I chose by mistake for Windows Vista, but there is one for Windows XP. This one shows you the connection. These are the steps of by step for the connection. And later on, I will teach you a nice strategy for using the lab resources and the lab manual, because I don't like the idea of giving the students the lab manual and asking them to follow it step by step. Your task is to show them how to do it, and their task to open the lab manual, but refer whenever it's